Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Youth Education System for Agriculture Engineering Students. Now today's topic is Elementary Agriculture Engineering, an introduction to the farm machinery. I am Engineer Gargi Shekhar, Assistant Professor in Department of Agriculture at Mayo Group of Colleges, Silakui, Dehradun. Now talking about farm machinery, I'll just give you a preview of farm machinery today in this upcoming video. Now, then introduction to the agriculture machines. You must know that farm machinery is an implement that can be defined as any type of machinery or implement that can be used in the process of agricultural production. It can be for crop production or for animal production. Now, if we get inside this topic, you should understand that agricultural farm machineries or implements includes tillage implements like plows, subsoilers, harrows, planters, cultivators, implements for fertilizer applications, implements for crop protection, irrigation equipments, machinery for harvesting, implements for seed cleaning and preparation, implements for crop drying, storage equipments, equipments for livestock husbandry and milk processing, farm transport and material handling, machinery for land drainage and reclamations, etc. So now, getting inside the topic, what is the need of farm mechanization? The basic need of farm mechanization is among the most compelling importance of farm implements. The farm mechanization has following mentioned importance. The first is reducing human drudgery, increasing productivity, improving timeliness of agricultural operations such as planting and harvesting, and reducing the peak labor demands, etc. Then comes the major constraints in the farm mechanization. There are many constraints in farm mechanization. The first is small land holdings. The farmers with small land holdings can have some constraints in adopting the farm mechanization. Less investing capacity of the farmers is very important constraints for adopting farm mechanization. Lack of appropriate farm machine for different operations is the other constraint. Then comes the high cost of machines. Then is the inadequate quality control of machine. Then is lack of repair and servicing facilities for the machines. Lack of trained manpower, that is skilled labor, is again a constraint in the farm mechanization. Lack of coordination between the research organization and manufacturer is again a constraint in farm mechanization. And lastly, adequate availability of the draft animals becomes a main constraint in the farm mechanization. Now, talking about the source of farm power, the main sources of farm power is classified as human power, animal power, and mechanical power. Sometimes electrical power and renewable energy is also considered as the source of farm power. Now talking about the next topic, that is the human power. Human being exerts their physical strength either directly by walking, pushing, pulling, pressing, lifting, carrying, throwing, or indirectly by means of tools which transmit and increase their manual skills in innumerable ways. The average force a man or a human being can exert is equal to the 1/10 of his or her own weight. So if you want to calculate it, you can just calculate by the weight to the 1/10 of it. Now, talking about the next one, that is the merits and demerits of the human power. You must know there are certain merits of human power, that is, it is very easily available and it is used for all type of works. There are certain demerits also, since it is an expensive source of power compared to all other forms of power. It has very low efficiency, it requires full maintenance when not in use, and it is affected by weather and conditions and their seasons. Next comes the animal power. Oxen, buffaloes, mules, horses, donkeys, and of course camels are commonly used for draught and pack animals in different parts of the world. Animals either carry or pull loads, pulling being best suited to them. Animal draught can also be used to drive stationary machineries. Animals can also be used for field puddling and threshing grains by trampling. Normally, the pulling power of an animal is directly proportional to its weight and corresponds very roughly to 1/10 of it. Successful use of animals for draught purpose depends on how they are tamed, trained, and harnessed. So, you can understand that the animal power is again a very important source of power for agricultural benefits. Now, talking about the merits and demerits, the animal power has certain merits, like it is again easily available, used for all type of works. It has low initial investment, supplies manures and fuels, and lives on the farm products. But it has certain demerits too, since it is not very efficient. Seasons and weather affect the efficiency. It cannot work at a stress. Then requires full maintenance when not in use and is very slow in doing work. So these are certain merits and demerits. Now talking about the mechanical power, in the early 19th century, steam engines were used in agriculture. The steam power unit was bulky and heavy, hence it was cumbersome and not applicable to many of the jobs found on the farms. Today, most of the field power comes from internal combustion engines, and most of these engines are mounted on the tractors. So the basic source of mechanical power is the tractors. It has certain merits and demerits too. If we talk about the merit, it is having high efficiency. It is not affected by any kind of weather or season. It can work at a stretch. It requires less space and is cheaper from other form of powers. But there are certain demerits, like it has initial capital investment which is very high. It is having fuel, and that fuel consumption is very costly. Repair and maintenance needs technical knowledge, that is, skilled labors are required. Now comes the next functional analysis of the agricultural machines. An agriculture machine has components that work together as a system in order for the machine to perform at its intended functions. To understand how the machine works, consider the machine as a collection of several systems made up of components and of several components. Then comes this is the figure, which is system of agricultural machineries. You can observe over here, the agriculture machines need support system, which includes the frame, power and control, and process system, which is reversible, irreversible and non-directional. So you can observe that the systems of agricultural machine is quite complicated. Then comes the process systems, that are those components that the machines are actually performing the functions that machine is designed to perform, that is cutting, separating, mixing, etc. Then is the support system, in which the parts that support or aid the process system in performing their functions are utilized. Now next comes the process systems, which is irreversible processes, includes the process such as separation and compaction. Non-reversible processes including cutting and grinding. Examples of the non-directional processes are conveying, metering, storing materials, etc. So you have seen that there are different process systems which are very important for our use of machineries. Now comes the support system. The framing system consists of all structural parts of the machine that hold pieces together so they are functionally properly, and the control system that provides control over the process system, power system that supply power to the process system. Then next comes the self-propelled machines that contain both power source, that is engine and power transmission devices, like the drivetrain. The machines that depend on the tractor as a power source contain power transmission devices such as chains, belts, gears, PTO shafts, etc. Together, these devices form the power system which derives the process system. Next comes the basic process of agricultural machines. The reversible process includes mixing, separating, fluff, pack, pickup, deposit, scatter and position. The non-reversible process includes dissociate, cut, crush and grind. And non-directional process includes convey, meter and store. Now the process diagrams is the diagram which is formed by following the flow of material through the machine and listing the processes in order. The process can be connected with the lines to indicate the flow of material through the machine. Any of the process can occur either totally within the machine or with the machine mobility as a part of process. For example, the forward motion of the baler is essential to pick up the hay. However, after hay is picked up, it will be baled regardless to the forward motion of the machine. So you should understand that the process diagrams are very important to work in this direction. In this, you can see here that when the machine mobility is part of the process is enclosed in the box, that is XX. And the process occurring together within the machine is enclosed in a circle or an oval, that is WW to ZZ. Now, I'll just give some examples of these type of processes. The first example is tillage with the moldboard plow. The first step is to determine what processes occur as the plow moves through the soil. As the plow moves forward, the soil is cut, picked up, positioned and deposited. The second step is to determine whether the processes are dependent upon the forward motion or not. In case the moldboard plow, all functions would cease as soon as the plow is stopped. So next is the process diagram of the moldboard plow. You can see here. Cut, pick up, position and then deposit. That is, the plow will first of all cut, picking up and positioning occurs simultaneously and therefore are diagrammed as a pair. Now the second example I am going to use is, as discussed already, about the hay baler. The baling with the hay baler is a more complex machine to diagram is a conventional hay baler. The processes that occur in the machine are pick up, convey, meter, cut, pack, bind, convey and deposit. The process which is dependent upon the forward motion of the baler is pick up. So you should understand that the process diagram comes like this. First pick up, then convey and meter, then cut, pack, bind and deposit. Now, when we are designing any kind of farm machinery, the fine farm machinery design involves predicting the failure, analysis, selection. Then comes the selection of most promising solution for more detailed analysis, detailed design, prototyping and testing, iterations, availability of the power requirement and sources of power, functional requirements of the machine, it is in interrelationship of various components, optimum expected life of the machine, that is approximately 2000 hours, strength requirements of the various components, material selection based on the force analysis and availability in the local market, wear characteristics of various components, ease of operation of various components of a machine, reliability of the components and the machine. So these 8 are the design parameters of the farm machinery. Some more farm machinery design parameters are also there, which we'll be discussing in this upcoming slides, like the possibility of the designing a multi-purpose machine combining more than one function into a single machine, cost of the machine and farmer's paying capacity, ease of operation, adjustment and maintainability, safety aspects, human factors in design, aesthetic appeal and durability of the machine, cultural requirements of the community, suggestions and feedbacks from the users, other competitive products in the market. So you must have all these 17 parameters in mind when you are trying to design any kind of farm machinery implement. Then comes the next criteria, that is, if we are talking about the cultural requirements of the community, the design of the machine differs from other machines. The farm machine should be capable of performing its functions under the variety of conditions. The variation in the conditions may be due to geographical location of the field, crop growth and season, specific needs of the farmer, farm size and production trains. Method of control and adjustment of the machine should be adequately simple. The machine should easily operate reliably in action and other functions. So now we'll move on to the next design criteria, like the normal life expectancy of the farm machine is about 2000 hours of use. Many machines are used for a few hours in a year, that is sowing, planting, machinery. The designer should aim at lowest cost of construction of the machine. The farm machine comes to a work, rather work coming to the machine. Most of the farm machines perform various functions in motion, mostly on uneven and bumpy grounds. For example, rotavators, combine harvesters, vertical conveyor reapers, root crop harvesters, etc. Safety should be kept in mind, that is, proper engineering device design of agricultural machine can reduce number of accidents on the farms. And lastly, if we are talking about the majority of the agricultural machine manufacturers have a volume of productions less than 5,000 units per year, that makes economic design different from other machines. Human factors in the farm machine redesign, several environmental variables and machine parameters can materially affect the person's performance while operating a machine in actual field conditions. If we are talking about these, there are certain factors like air temperature, humidity and purity, noise level, vibration, seat design, arrangement of this workspace, placement of the controls and instruments, shape and coding of the controls, amount of the physical efforts required for controls, overall visibility of the machine components and functions that needs to be watched. So these factors are additional factors which are required while designing any kind of farm machines. Then the equipment designed with proper application of human factor principles can lead to the following performance results, that is, increased efficiency and productivity, increased reliability, improved safety, decreased operator's effort, improved flexibility and increased comfort and better operator and consumer occupancy. The draft and power requirements of the farm machinery vary from the farm to another farm, on the same farm from the location to location, season to season and from year to year. However, common ranges are available from literature that can be used. The design of the frames of the farm machines depends to the soil compaction propelling power, and it should be light as possible to reduce the cost, but strong enough to resist the shocks due to rough fields or obstacles. Then comes the design features of a well-designed farm machine. A well-designed farm machine should have following important features for satisfactory performance at user level. The first is efficient use of this power source, efficient use of the human power in doing work, best possible quality of the work with minimum cost, adequate strength and easily workable, machinable and cheaper material of construction. Now we will be talking about fewer parts to reduce the cost and complexity of the machine, standard and interchangeable parts, simple in construction, resistance to the mechanical wear due to friction, corrosion resistant, provided with the appropriate safety devices and low cost of repair. So these are certain criteria which we always keep in mind while we are designing any kind of farm machines. So that is all about the introduction to the farm machineries. Thank you. Have a nice day.